Welcome to Knowledge Hut. In today's video, we're going to learn some basics of project scheduling, including the determination of Slack values and finding the critical path. We'll be dealing with the activities, the expected activity duration, earliest start time, earliest finish time, latest start time, and latest finish time in the whole operation. Now, suppose activity A and B are without any predecessors. Therefore, these activities can begin at the start of the project. Activity C needs A to be complete before it can start. D requires both A and B to be completed. E needs D to be completed. F needs both C and E to be completed. And G requires E to finish first. Since there are no activities after F and G, therefore both of them can go to the finish. Now, this is how the network will look with activity nodes. The numbers below the activity name represent the time required by the respective activities. Let us do the forward pass. A is the first activity, so it can start right away. Therefore, its earliest start time will be 0. It will take 7 days to be completed, so its earliest finish time will be 0 plus 7 equals 7 days. Similarly, B will have the earliest start time of 0 and earliest finish time of 9. C needs A to finish first, and we have already seen that A has the earliest finish time of 7. Therefore, earliest start time for C will be 7. After these 7 days, C will take 12 days to complete, and therefore the earliest finish time of C will be 12 plus 7 equals 19. D needs both A and B to finish first. A has the earliest finish time of 7 days, and B has 9 days, so we can say that on day 9, both these activities will be finished. Therefore, earliest start time for D will be 9. Now D will finish in 8 plus 9 equals 17 days. E has only D as its predecessor, so it can start as soon as D ends. After going on for 9 days, it'll end on the 26th day of the project. F needs E and C to finish first. Both of them will not finish before 26, as E has the earliest finish at 26. Therefore, F can start at the earliest at around 26 and finish at 32 after consuming its 6 days. G only has one predecessor, E, and E will finish on 26. Therefore, G can start at the earliest at 26, and it can finish at the earliest at 26 plus 5 equals 31. As we can see that the last activity to finish is F, which will finish on day 32. Therefore, we can say that the project will take 32 days. Now, let's do the backward pass. Since the project completion time is 32 days, F and G cannot take more time than 32 days. Therefore, the latest finish time for both of these activities has to be 32 days. Now, let us start calculating the latest start times of activities by subtracting the activity time from the latest finish time. For G, it will be 32 minus 5 equals 27. For F, it will be 32 minus 6 equals 26. Now, E has F and G as its successors, and their latest start time is 26 and 27 respectively. So E has to finish at 26 in order for F to start on the same day. By now, you must have observed that while doing a backward pass, the latest finish time of an activity must be the minimum of the latest start time of its successor. Thus, for E, the latest start time will be 26 minus 9 equals 17. Since D has only E as its successor, the latest start time for E becomes D's latest finish time, and the latest start time will be 17 minus 8 equals 9. Similarly, C has only F as its successor. Therefore, the latest finish time for C is 26, and the latest start time would be 26 minus 12 equals 14. Now A has C and D as its successors, and the minimum of their latest start is 9. Therefore, A's latest finish will also be 9, and its latest start will be 9 minus 7 equals 2. Similarly, B has D as its successor, with the latest start of 9, which becomes B's latest finish, and therefore B's latest start becomes 0. Here finishes our backward pass. Now let us calculate the slack for each activity. Slack is the delay which we can allow in an activity such as a way that it does not cause any delays in the deadline of a project. The formula for calculating slack is LS minus ES, or LF minus EF. So, for A, it can be 2 minus 0, or 9 minus 7, which is 2. For B, it will be 0, 7 for C. For D, E, and F, it will be 0 again. And for G, it will be 1. Now, the slack of 7 days in C shows that it can be delayed for 7 days without causing any delay in the project. C can begin any time between day 7 and day 14. Also, it can end at any time between day 19 and 26. All the activities with zero slack cannot be delayed without extending the project completion time. All such activities are called critical activities. The path they form is known as critical path, which is the longest path in the network. Here, B, D, E, and F form the critical path. So, this was all about project scheduling and critical path. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos, and visit our website to choose from hundreds of professional courses for your bright career ahead. Thanks so much for being with Knowledge Hut.